Hello, I'm going to do the Leo energy reading for the week of February 18th to the 24th. As always, take what resonates, leave what does not. So I have my cards ready to go here. And we're going to look at what you may be struggling with or what the conflict is for the week. What do you need to focus on? What do you need to look at? And future energies possibly coming in for you. All right, so we have... What you may be struggling with is Six of Pentacles, so it could have to do with sharing. Eight of Wands and Ten of Swords, putting an end to something. I feel like you're struggling with putting an end to something. I feel like you're kind of hanging on to something, or there's something that is still bothering you. It could be something that somebody said or something that somebody did, and that you're hanging on to that energy, and that I almost feel like with the Six of Pentacles here, which is like sharing and that back and forth, I feel like you're kind of keeping something to yourself, and then you're not really speaking with that person, or you're not speaking up about a situation that is bothering you, and that you're holding it all in. And I feel like that's starting to build up within yourself, which I feel like that kind of represents that Eight of Wands, is that it's starting to build up within yourself, and it's something that needs to come to an end, because I feel like you don't realize how much it's starting to affect you, and that it's making things harder for you. And holding on to things, sometimes we feel like if we hold on to something, or if we have a tidbit of information where somebody did something that bothered us, or and they were in the wrong, and then we kind of hold that and we're like, okay, well, if they irritate me later, then I'm just going to blast them with it. But holding on to that is not affecting the other person. It's affecting you. It's affecting, because that is something that is in the back of your mind, or that, you know, is still kind of irritating you or still bothers you. And that when you're holding on to that, it's really working against yourself. It's not really working for yourself. And that sometimes it's better just to let that go and to move on from that. So let's grab some wisdom of the Oracle. So we have mending, see? That's what I was feeling, is that there's a situation that happened that you haven't gotten over, that you haven't moved past, that you're still holding on to, that you're still, even if you may have said, yeah, I'm past it or I'm over it, I feel like you're still holding on to it. And I feel like that's something that you have to realize, and that you have to, we have building blocks that you have to move on from. We have building blocks, and then what else do we have for Leo that they're struggling with, right? That you're, yeah. And then we have why. So I feel like with holding on to this situation and not having this mending, I feel that it's affecting your foundation. I feel that it's affecting your building blocks. And I feel that it's like you're creating a tower. And the tower card in the tarot is that, you know, something is built on a false foundation. And I feel like that's kind of what you're doing here, is you're kind of having this foundation that has cracks in it, or that has problems in it. And this is something that you're contributing to that. And I feel like that's something that you need to realize and ask yourself, why are you holding on to that? And why do you feel the need to hold back and to not express your feelings, or not, you know, speak your truth? And why do you feel that, you know, does that give you more of a sense of control within yourself? Do you feel that that's giving you more control in a situation? And it's really not. It's really kind of working against yourself. And I feel like that's something that you need to focus on. Let's look at what you need to focus on for Leo with this situation. Let's see, we had one that, I'm almost positive we had one that turned over. I'm pretty sure there's one that turned over. Maybe not. All right. Those two turned over. All right, we have Knight of Pentacles moving forward, right? What do you need to focus on? Ten of Pentacles. And Hierophant. And the Hierophant can represent someone that you trust and somebody that you believe in and somebody that you feel that you can have a conversation with and that they will give you true advice. Sometimes we have those people in our lives that they're going to tell it like it is, even though we don't really want to hear it. Sometimes we don't want to hear it. But we know that they're being honest and that they're being truthful and that they're going to tell us the way, you know, how it is. I also feel that it's about restoring your own faith and belief in yourself and giving yourself that guidance and trusting yourself and getting yourself back on track and saying, okay, I don't really need to be focusing on these things, right? That I don't really need to be focusing on these things here that are really draining you. And, you know, creating that false foundation and creating those cracks in that foundation. And it's time to move forward with that Knight of Pentacles. And it's time to take those steps to regain that Ten of Pentacles, right? And that sometimes it's not about being right. It's about doing the right thing. And I just feel like with this mending here, I feel that, and I also feel like you're holding back your feelings and you're really holding back how you feel about something. And I feel like it's also, it's not about doing it for the other person. It's about doing it for yourself to set yourself free from that. And I feel like that's really what it's all about here. And sometimes it's hard to see that when you're trying to do it the way that you want to do it. I'm like trying to put it in a nice way. So that the rewards are greater, that if you're just able to like mend it and move on and move to the next phase, you know, like move to the next thing and just say, you know what, let me just mend this. Let me just, you know, get past this, and holding on to this energy really isn't serving me. Let's grab some Wisdom of the Oracle for Leo. Come to the Edge. And then we have Co-Create, Working Together. I feel like it's almost like take a chance with that Come to the Edge. And then we have Here and Now, being in the moment right now, looking at the situation for what it is right now. Maybe it's something that happened in the past. Maybe it's something that a person did a long time ago that you're still holding on to, that you said that you forgave them, or you said you moved on, or you're trying to convince yourself that you've moved on from a situation. And maybe it's something that's happened in the past. But I feel like it's being in this moment now and seeing how that energy is affecting you in this moment and seeing what's going on with you right now in this moment and kind of realizing, okay, what can I do to move on from the situation? What can I do to let this go? What can I do to build a solid foundation? You know, why? And asking yourself, why do I feel the need that I have to hold on to this? Why do I feel the need that I have to keep going through this and keep reminding myself of this and keep putting myself in this energy? All right. Being here in the moment, here and now, not what happened in the past, not what's in the future, but being in this moment. And I feel like that's the biggest thing, is that realizing, okay, what's going on in this moment right now? How do I feel in this moment right now? What is it that I need to work through? What is it that I need to process? What is it that I have to deal with in this moment right now? All right, future energies. We have the Five of Cups. kind of shifting your focus, right? Yes, you may be sad and upset about something that happened, but you have the two cups that are behind you. And then we have Seven of Pentacles, kind of taking a break and kind of saying, you know what, kind of looking over the whole situation and saying, okay, realizing, okay, I don't want to put myself in this energy again, and kind of reevaluating things and saying, am I spending too much time? Am I spending too much energy on things that really don't serve me? You know, do I need to forgive? Do I need to mend? Do I need to work through things? You know, and it could just be mending yourself too. Do I need to work on those things, you know, sooner? And then I felt like two more. We have the Page of Pentacles. Pages is young, new energy, kind of starting out new and fresh and kind of like on that new path. And then we have the King of Wands. Again, looking over, so I feel like that kind of represents Leo is the King of Wands, is kind of looking over and saying, learning from the past and saying, do I really want to put myself in that energy again? Do I really want to go through that again? Do I really want to keep putting myself in that situation? And kind of learning from the past and saying, okay, if I see that I'm holding on to something, or I'm, you know, saying that I'm over something and I'm not, that, you know, maybe I need to readjust that. Maybe I need to rethink that. And I need to let it go. I just feel like it's letting it go, letting things go and not holding on to something. Mending, fixing those bridges is, and it's not about the other person, it's about yourself and saying, looking out for yourself and saying, okay, this isn't something that I have to do for me. Let's grab To Be Fair, doing it for you. That's exactly what I was just saying, is that you're doing it for you, even though it is solving a problem and maybe it's helping that other person out too, but it's like, it's also helping yourself. And then we have peace. Finding that peace within yourself and being so proud and saying that this isn't something that you have to deal with anymore, that this isn't something that you have to think about. This isn't something that's going to be affecting all of your choices and your movements forward. And then we have clean it up, time to get to it, time to make things happen. Peace, create that peace. So we have mending and we have peace and we have clean it up, and you know, it's the here and now. And I just feel like it's, there's a situation that's going on with you that's bothering you. And I feel like it's bothering you maybe more than what you realize. And it's creating that peace for yourself and looking out for yourself and saying, you know what? This is bothering me. This is affecting me. This is making me feel a certain way, and that I have to look out for myself. And that it, even though it may be something that I don't really want to deal with, or I'm not used to doing things this way, but I have to create peace within myself. And this is a way that I can create peace, is mending and cleaning up a situation and dealing with a situation and truly moving on from it. Let's grab a animal oracle. We have Badger Spirit. Be fearless and bold, being strong, right? Being that true Leo and being strong and being fearless and being bold and facing the situation for what it is, right? And saying, okay, yeah, like I really am hanging on to this. I haven't forgiven and I haven't forgotten, and it's bothering me and it's affecting me and it's making me aggravated and irritated. And, you know, being strong and standing up for yourself and saying, I need to make changes that work for me, not against me. We have a Star Dragon's Wisdom, asking questions, asking questions. So I feel like it's really asking yourself a lot of questions, because we had the why came out too. So here we are with two different cards from two different decks saying, you know, asking those questions, like, why are you holding on to an energy, or why are you feeling a certain way, and asking yourself those questions, why? And like, why are you doing that? And I do that a lot with myself, is that I'll just be like, okay, if something's bothering me, and I'll literally, like, I'll talk to myself and I'll say, why is this bothering me? Or why do I feel hurt? Or why am I afraid? You know, what am I afraid of for making this choice or decision? Or why do I feel that I don't want to express myself, or, you know, speak up for myself or do something? So, and asking yourself those questions, why? So I feel like since that came out twice, I feel like there's definitely things that you need to ask yourself. And finding out more about yourself. And I feel like a lot of people, like, they don't really know. Like, sometimes when you ask, people are like, I don't know what makes me happy. I don't know what would make me happy. I don't know what I would want to do. I don't know what's on my bucket list. I don't know, you know, and it's just about finding about more about yourself and asking those questions. Let's get a whispers of healing. We have meditation. So I feel like meditation represents that quiet time to yourself where you're able to think through things. Finding that space where that quiet time, sometimes people don't like that quiet time. They don't like things to be quiet. They don't like things because then they're like, oh, but then I think, and then I think too much, or, you know, things starts to bubble up. But maybe that's something that you need to confront. Maybe that's something that you need to deal with. You know, maybe it's time to deal with that and work through that and free yourself from it. I know I've had a lot of things that I've had to deal with that have bubbled up. And as I get older, like, you can't keep that mental chest closed. It just kind of starts to open up. And I've dealt with a lot of things, and I'm really happy that I did. And it's given me a lot of freedom and independence from those things that have been holding me back. I mean, I still feel like I have more to do, but nothing like what I used to have. And it feels good. It doesn't feel good going through it. It's a process, and it's a lot of emotions and feelings. And but it definitely feels good to be on the other side and to have worked through those things and to not have those things affect me and my choices, and not realizing how much those things really did and how much those things really do. And meditation is that quiet time where I feel like it's kind of representing, you know, not having not having a lot of noise around you. Where is that place that you find that you can have quiet time and you can think? For me, I like to go to the barn. And when I go out to the barn, it's that quiet time. And just driving out to the barn, it's about a 30-minute drive, and it's a nice drive. And I can really think about things, and I kind of have the music on low, and there's no distractions, and I'm really able to kind of find answers and figure things out for myself, and it feels good. So where is that place where you can have that quiet time? Let's grab a Oracle Tarot. For Leo. Whoa. I don't want all those to spill out. Ah. All right, let's try that again. All right, that one turned over. All right, so we have the Seven of Pentacles, which is patience and planning. Having patience with the process. Sometimes that could be a lesson within itself, is just learning patience and saying, okay, this is a process that you're going through, and, you know, asking yourself those questions and figuring out what's truly bothering you and working on that mending and finding that place and cleaning something up. I feel like that it has to do a lot with that mental work of cleaning up, like, what's affecting you and what's bothering you, and realizing that that's going to take some time, and that to have patience with that, and that sometimes you feel like you're moving ahead two spots, and then you're going backwards. And sometimes that happens, but that's okay. But I still feel, in the grand scheme of things, you really are moving forward, because when you're facing things and you're dealing with things, I feel that it's definitely a way to work through things. Let's grab a Angel Answers for Leo. I kind of feel like two. I feel like this one and that one. So we have, you are ready, right? You are ready. I feel like you're ready. I feel like you're ready to really listen and to really hear and to really work on things and ask yourself those questions, because I feel like you're tired of this space that you're in. I feel like you're tired of this situation that you're in, and I feel like it's exhausting you, and you're like, you know what, time has come to make some changes and some choices. And then we have look at that. So you have two meditation brings answers. Look at that. So from two different decks, you have meditation. All right, so that's kind of a strong message for you. So we had two different decks, two different cards that say meditation. And you have two different cards from two different decks that say why, and asking questions. And so I feel like that's what you need to do in that quiet time, in that space that you have, and really asking yourself those questions and doing that self-care and working on yourself. But I feel like it's kind of stepping away from the situation and just calming the mind and quieting your mind. And that brings answers, and that brings you clarity, and that brings you direction. Sometimes that's not really what we want to hear, but it's finding the answers within yourself. It's finding the direction within yourself and saying, okay, if something's bothering me, I've got to look out for myself. I've got to step up to the plate, and I've got to change things, and really doing that for yourself. So we have a crystal card for the week, and then we have this blue one here, kind of an odd looking stone. Blue aragonite. Empathy, compassion, communication. Communication is key, and with blue aragonite, you will definitely send the message. This crystal activates the throat, third eye, and heart chakras, allowing you to communicate from a whole and centered place, while the stone instills hope and inspiration. So I like that it says that, because I feel like it represents, because I said over here is that I felt like you had trouble sharing it, and I feel like it had to do with communication and doing that back and forth. But maybe it's like you're not even sure what it is that you want to say, or maybe you're not even sure what it is that's bothering you. And so that's why you have this meditation time, is for you to figure that out and to have that clarity and say, you know what, it, like, you know how they say, like, sometimes when people have arguments about the dishes in the sink, it's not really about the dishes in the sink. It's really about something deeper, something that's really bothering them inside. So I feel like maybe that's why it keeps saying meditation, is that you need that quiet time to really figure out what's really bothering you, and what's really getting to you, and what's really irritating you, and what is the heart of the problem here. And then you're able to communicate clearly, either to yourself or to the other person, and say, you know, this is really what's bothering me. This is really what's what the heart of the problem is, and this is really what's going on for me. So this crystal helps with that. It helps to align yourself. It's helped to have that inner knowing and that intuition, and listening to that self and really connecting with self and saying, okay, this is truly what's bothering me. This crystal enhances your ability to empathize and show compassion for others, fostering authentic connections. And it could be also about learning to see the situation from the other person's point of view, that maybe you're just seeing things from your point of view, but you're not understanding, and you're not truly listening to that other person. And you want that person to truly understand and listen to your side. And that happens a lot in communications and miscommunications, actually, where one person, or maybe both, are not really understanding. Like, someone may say, well, this is bothering me, but the other person may say, well, it shouldn't bother you because that's not what it was meant to do. But it's acknowledging that if it's bothering that person, acknowledging and saying, okay, I understand that it's bothering you, and that it won't happen again, or that things will change, or that, you know, just having that compassion and realizing, okay, even though it may not bother you, it's bothering that person, and to acknowledge that. And that goes a long way, and that creates deeper relationships and understanding between you and that person. And because that person is like, oh, okay, they may not get why I'm upset, but they understand that I am, and they are acknowledging that. This crystal's communication skills also can carry across when you are communicating with the spirit realm, cultivating a calm and relaxed space for even more clarity to come through. So a calm and relaxed space, I feel like that also goes back to meditation and that quiet time and having that calm and relaxed space. So you're able to, for even more clarity to come through. So I feel like it's asking yourself those questions, and that clarity as, what is your next step? So I feel like that crystal kind of wraps up everything that's going on here, is to, you know, realize that. So maybe next week is the week that you take that time and you have that quiet time. You start working through things. You start asking yourself those questions, and you find that time to have that peace and that quiet time to clean this situation up and start working on it. It may take longer to come to a resolution, but kind of realizing and, you know, have that patience like we had here, patience and planning, and kind of saying, having that patience and saying, well, at least you know what's going on, you know what's happening, and you're ready to make some changes. So that's the biggest thing. That's the hardest step, is saying, okay, I realize, I see what's going on, I see what's happening, I see that I have to work on something, I see that I have to ask myself questions and I need to change things up, and that what's my next step. And just realizing that, I feel, is the biggest step. All right, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. I hope you have an amazing day. As always, stay positive, stay safe, and I will see you next time.